Hi all, welcome to John's Model Makers. Today we've got Valentino Rossi, issues 32 to 36. Excellent stuff. Now the first four issues, 32 to 35, we're adding parts onto the engine. And here is that engine, looking absolutely beautiful. I'll show you a close-up shot of that. Issue 36 is the airbox. There we go, there's the engine. Looking absolutely brilliant. I love the contrast with the parts for the engine. As you can see, it's not all silver, but we are adding to this today. Yep, excellent stuff. Also, I received a replacement issue 15, which is this display. As you can see, that looks perfect, no blemishes on it. The original one did have blemishes on it, so they sent me a replacement. Quick fix, but that is brilliant. And there's the airbox that we add to in issue 36. So for now, let's have a look at issue 32. And here we have issue 32 through the magazine. Absolutely brilliant pictures in here as always. And in the instructions, clutch, hub and plates. This is pretty straightforward. Just put them rings together. They're the parts. So, let's get on with the build. Okay, okay. Here we got the parts, let's get them out. There we go, those are the parts. So we got A, which is a clutch hub. We have the center ring, which is B. We have the first plate, which is C. And we have the three intermediate plates. And basically, all we do with this, is take this. Now you can see the notches on this ring, rather than on bar, so they've got to be faced up. Once how the groove in the plate fits over the rib identified in step one, as indicated by the yellow circle. And this is the same with the three intermediate plates, protruding just like that. And these three basically will go over the top, should go. There we go, nice tight fit that one. Each like that. These are the intermediate ones. Doesn't matter which way up these go, because they're both on the same side. I should say they look the same on that side and that side. But there is a groove that fits over that rib on the side there. That goes like that. There we go, that's them four rings in place. Now the last ring, as you can see, is a little groove just there. Yep. And we have to fit it this way up over them two pegs like so. There we go. Oh, we can see that all right. Yep. And as you can see, there we go, it's all them notches nicely lined up. Excellent stuff. That is issue 32 complete. Okay, now issue 33, we have Valentino the rally driver. That's an excellent read. And here we have the parts, oil V cover and final clutch parts. There we go, can add that to the engine, put the hose pipe on it. And here we go, we finish that clutch off and we pop that into place as well. Excellent, let's get on with the build. Here are the parts. There we go, so we got the oil feed cover, the short hose, the clutch pressure plate, friction plate and the clutch sensor. Excellent stuff. Okay, so we're going to need the engine for this. Here we have the engine and there we go. So we pop that into them two holes there. Move that pipe out to the right so you can see it there and there. You can see the shape of it. It's just the push fit connection. And excellent. There we go. Now we do need this hose. And this hose, I believe, fits onto here. Just like that. That's correct. Yep, that's looking brilliant. So that's the oil feed cover. Excellent. Next we need the short hose, which fits on here. I'm being lucky because I'm not allowed to expand the... I think I'm going to have to open this one up. I've spoke too soon. All these pipes have been going on too easy for me. Well, this one goes on here as well. So let me turn that around a little bit easier for myself. So we can pop that there. Yeah, it's best I open this up. Cocktail stick, pop the hose in. There we go, expand it a little bit. That should enable us to get it onto there, which it does. Yep. Sometimes you're reluctant to use tweezers because it crimps the, there we go, the pipe. But it will come back to its normal state anyway, the pipe. There we go. Crimp that. Open that hose with a cocktail stick. Pull that out. And hopefully this time I can get it into place. Nope. Well, let me do that again. Leave that up for a second and then we'll try again. There we go. Finally did it. That took some persuading, I'll tell you. That little pip there, or nipple, seems to be larger than the other one. Well, there we go. That is now in place and it's definitely not coming off. Okay, done. Next thing we need are these two pieces. And I have two pegs there and there going that hole and that hole there. I don't think it's any specific. There we go. Excellent. That is just push fit again. Excellent. There we go. That's gone round nicely. Should look exactly like that. There we go. And now we need issue 32 back, and as you can see, two holes there and there, and that will go into there just like that. And I forgot that piece which goes on the top, which is not a problem because it will go into them two holes there. Push that in. There's always one that's tougher than the other. There we go. That is that all nicely in place. Now we can put this onto the engine. Yep. A tight fit these, which is brilliant because you know they're not going to come apart. Here we have the engine and it goes here and here, them two pegs. Just like that. Excellent. There we go. Brilliant. That is looking superb. So there's that oil feed cover and now that clutch now. Beautifully in place. Excellent stuff. That's issue 33. Let's move on. Okay, so now we have issue 34. We have the coolant system for this. And here we have the Czech Grand Prix. Valentino winning another one, of course. There we have the coolant system and alternator. So we have the hose, top pipe, alternator, end cover, and the alternator. All these are push fit connections, of course. Here we have. There's the final result. Excellent. Let's get on with the build. Okay, there we got the parts. Okay, up there's the pipes and there's the alternator, so we don't need that. We need this top pipe first, and we need the engine again. Now we need it this way around, and we can pop that into them two slots there and there. So line that up there and there. Again, that's nice. Went in quite easy, but if you want, you could put glue on it, and then basically we just have the pipe left. Now looking at that, I don't think it matters which way that goes. That will just fit over the top just like that. Yeah, and it does stick out to one side just like that. Now we need the alternator. Right, here we have the alternator. Got three pegs, three holes, and it is a case of just lining them up. I think that will go, yep, just like that. Pop that together, and then we can pop this onto the engine. If I can remember where it goes. Ah, there it is. There is. Yep, there's two pegs there, two holes there. It will go that way around and just press into place. You can line that up. Now that is not a tight fit. Not like that clutch assembly. I'm not sure if that's going to come off. No, it shouldn't come off that. There you go, that's brilliant. Excellent stuff. So we got that top pipe and its hose and the alternator in place. Excellent, that's issue 34, believe it or not. Let's move on. Okie doke, so now we've got issue 35. Made in Tavola. Made in Tavolia. Oh, visit Tavolia, where Valentino started his career. Excellent stuff. Nice signature as well. And in the instructions, we have the inlet manifolds, injectors, and throttle bar. So you have cylinders 1 and 2, manifold, cylinders 3 and 4, manifold, cylinders 1 and 2 ejectors, and cylinders 3 and 4 ejectors, and the throttle bar. Excellent stuff. There we go. So we do put these into the engine, and that is the final result. Excellent stuff. Let's get on with the build. Here we have the parts. Let's get these out now. Okay, so now we got the parts. We got A, which is cylinders 1 and 2 manifold, B, which is cylinders 3 and 4 manifold, C, which is cylinders 1 and 2 injectors, and D, which is cylinders 3 and 4 injectors, and we have the throttle bar. Now we're supposed to marry these up, A with C, B with D. So I'll just pop that to one side. This is A and C. Now looking at that, that is supposed to go, nope, like that, nope, that is not correct, that is how it, yeah, no, should be that way, but that is wrong. Looking at the instructions, it does fit in better though. That way is far too loose anyway, but it's the wrong way. It should fit that way, but as you can see, that tab there and that tab there are basically in the wrong positions. There we go, there's a closer look at that. That is wrong. That is supposed to be A, but I think that is B, and B will fit just there like that. Now that is how it should look according to the instructions. That hole there and that position there and there, they're only push fits. As you can see, that marries up with that corner there, or that end there, yeah, and that protrudes out there like that. Now that is how it should be, and this will do exactly the same. Yep, so that will fit there and there, and that is a nice tight fit. If I put it in the other way, it's too loose. I'm looking at the instructions, that's how it's shaped, not the way. I think they've just done the instructions wrong. A is B and B is A. But now we need the engine back. Can put these into place. And move that out of there. They go here and here. Okay, so pop pop that one in there, like so. I think that will stay in. And this one can go in here. I think that one's staying as well. It's not fully down that. Because what you need with these is that hole and that hole in them positions. Then we can get this throttle bar in place, which goes over the top. We'll go there and there. But first of all, there's a bit of a gap here, so I need to close that up. Oh, there we go. That's the best I can get that into place. It is a nice tight fit now, so that's brilliant. Now all we need is this bar, which can go, put that down there, in there, and in there. Excellent. Just like that. Brilliant. There we go. That is exactly how it should look in the instructions. Brilliant stuff. So that is issue 34 completed. Excellent stuff. Sorry, that is issue 35 completed. Let's move on to the last issue. Okay, no, last issue. Issue 36. 6 classic wins for Rossi. Excellent stuff. Yeah, he is looking all nice and sweaty. Fair few pages on his racing achievements. And now we have the inlet manifolds. Excellent. So we've put the manifolds together. These bars. These support bars. And then we pop it into the other box. And we don't see it again. There we go. Excellent stuff. So there's the air box with the cover. And we pop it in there and pop that cover on there. And, well, I suppose you'll see something through them holes. But you can always take that off and have a look if you wish. Anyway, let's get on with the build. Here we have the parts, so let's get the molds. Okay, now. So we have A, which is the front support bar, B, which is the rear support bar, C is the left side bracket, and D is the right side bracket. And then we have the cylinders 1 and 2 inlet manifolds. Whoops, that one there. And we have F cylinders 3 and 4 inlet manifolds. Now the way to work these out is there's a flat edge here and the curved here. There we go. Curve there, flat there. That's what makes them different. So E and F. Excellent. So we can put E and F to one side because what we need is A, which goes into here, which is C there, like that, and this one, which is B, which is the rear one, goes into there, like so, and then the same on this side with D. Get them two support bars in line with the holes. There we go. That's them nicely married together. Excellent stuff. Looking brilliant. There we go. Now I need to turn that one a little bit, but we can do that. That's no problem. There we go. Those are support bars. A and B. Nicely positioned. Now what we need E and F. It goes there and there. Let me see if I can get a clearer shot. Here we go, that's a better shot. So we need these support bars. There's two holes, one there, one there, and as you can see, the two pegs, one there, and basically they will occupy them two holes. And that will go in there, and that back one will go in that one. You heard that nice little click. And we can do the same with this side with F. In there, and in there. That one doesn't seem to want to go. The back one's going in, I think. No, nope, doesn't want to see that one. Get that front one in. Let's turn a little bit. There we go. Make sure you get this flat edge on the outer. There we go. That is exactly how it should look. Brilliant stuff. There we go. You can see the pegs are pushed all the way through. It is a very tight fit, so be very, very careful. And as you can see, it is quite flexible, especially in the middle. So you want to put the pressure on here and here, here and here, obviously where the pegs go through the hose. But that is how that fits. Excellent. Now we can fit this into the airbox. So we need the airbox. And basically this will go in here. Like I said, the curved parts are in the middle and the straighter edges are on the outer. And they basically fit over there, and there. This way around, with the support bars facing towards you. Let's pop that into place. There we go. Excellent. So you're not really going to see them again. As you can see, how that fits into place. Excellent. Can be fiddly. I can put the cover on now. Where are the catches? I've got the catches. There's one, two holes, two pegs. That goes in there like that. And then, there we go. That's that airbox completed. And you don't see much, you see nothing. But that is that finished. But you can obviously take this off if you wish to. Excellent stuff. Let's have a look at the engine. So there we go, there's the engine with everything in place now. Looking absolutely fantastic. I'm not sure what the next five issues will be, but that is looking better every month. We have still got this pipe here free, but as you can see, everything is neatly into place. Just be wary, because all these were push fit today, and some go in nicely, others are much tighter fit. But bear with it and you'll get there in the end. Excellent stuff. That's issues 32 to 36 complete. Okay guys, so issues 32 to 36 complete. There's that engine looking absolutely superb. That is looking brilliant, that. Yep, looking absolutely fantastic. And there is that air inlet box with the parts that you know you can't see. Now, like I said before, I think it was issue 35, wasn't it? Yeah, issue 35. There we go. So A and B, which are these two, it doesn't correspond in the instructions. I had to swap them around because A marries up with C and B marries up with D. But when you look at the instructions, it doesn't work out that way. It's B with C and A with D. Yours might be different when they turn up, I don't know, or maybe it's just the instructions that are wrong. But just be aware of that, and also be aware of the fact that you get plenty of plastic bags. About time they change to paper, I think. Anyway, that is it for another month of the Valentino Rossi. Looking absolutely brilliant, this bike. I do love the detail on it. Looks absolutely fantastic. I was watching somebody on YouTube, he put his video on about a year ago, and he was spraying varnish on it, made it really stand out. But it stands out anyway because it's shiny in parts and duller in others. So that is a great contrast for me. Plus you got the gold and the black parts as well. And we got the blue nuts here as well. Yeah, there's three of them. There we go. Looks absolutely brilliant. I don't know how much of this engine we're going to see when it's on the bike, but we can always take covers off and have a look at it. But anyway, it's looking fantastic. Anyway, if you did like that, give us a big thumbs up, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next month for the next bar issues. Thanks for tuning in and watching. Bye for now.